The majority of the Committee on Judiciary, to which was referred House Bill 1543 FN, an act relative to the citizens' petition for redress of grievances by the legislature, having considered the same, report the same with the following resolution. Resolved that it is inexpedient to legislate. Representative Gary B. Richardson for the majority of the committee. The minority of the committee being unable to agree with the majority, report with the recommendation that the bill ought to pass. Representative Robert H. Rowe for the minority of the committee. The question before the House is on the adoption of the majority committee report of inexpedient to legislate on House Bill 1543. The chair recognizes the member from Fremont, Representative Itza.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, my honorable representatives. I introduced this bill because the people of this state are exasperated. They've been pushed to their limit. They are tired of suffering at the hands of town officials, state bureaucrats, and jurists. And when they take their issue to court, they very often find that the court sides with the abuser. Now, our Constitution has two very wonderful articles. Article 31 that says that the purposes we meet here is to redress the public grievances and to make such laws as are necessary for good government. And then 32, which says that the people have a right to have the wrongs they suffer and the grievances they suffer heard by this legislature. The people have a right to complain directly to us when they are abused by government. So I tried to introduce a petition for the redress of grievance on the behalf of a citizen. I went to Legislative Services and they said, we can't do that. We don't have that authorization. I looked at the law, and indeed, the law that authorizes Legislative Services only gives them the power to draft bills and resolutions. So I went to the House clerk and I said, how do I introduce a petition for the redress of grievance? And the answer was, she didn't know. So I dug a little deeper. And I found that until 1963, legislators wrote their own legislation. And that was how we introduced things into the House. And petitions were one of the things that we could introduce. When we created Legislative Services, we broke part of the system. Up until 1921, we had laws of due process for those who are party to a redress of grievance. In the next recodification, those laws were lost. Now, they weren't repealed. They were just kind of lost. They forgot to include them. Well, the answer was simple. Change the law. So 1543 empowers Legislative Services to draft petitions, and looking back to the prior laws, it creates a due process for those who are party to a redress of grievance. Now, it's very important that you understand exactly what we're dealing with. This is a positive right in our Constitution of the people. It's one of the few positive rights. And it's also important that you understand where it came from. The right to petition for redress of grievance comes from the English Bill of Rights, which states that Parliament has to meet frequently in order to hear grievances and make laws. And our Article 31 is just a restatement of that. It's even more important that you realize the gravity of refusing such petitions. You have to look at the 28th and final indictment in the Declaration of Independence. In every stage of these oppressions, we have petitioned for the redress. In the most humble terms, and our repeated petitions have been answered only by repeated injury. The Parliament took the petitions that had been forwarded to them by King George and pocketed at his instruction. The refusal of Parliament to hear the petition for the redress of grievance was the justification for the American War for Independence. This was so important that our founders included Article 31, our duty to hear the petitions, and then they included Article 32, which stated the people's right to have those petitions heard. And then they went even one step further. They included Article 10, which states that when all other methods of redress become ineffectual, that the people may and of a right ought to reform or replace this government. The doctrine of non-resistance against arbitrary power and oppression is absurd, slavish, destructive to the good and happiness of mankind. Have you ever heard more proud and bold and decisive language. Our Constitution requires that when their petitions for redress of grievance become ineffectual, that they reform or replace this government. Now, the beauty of this is we don't have to go to the lawyers in black robes to understand what was meant. All we have to do is go to our House journals. Because if we go there, we learn that the people who wrote and ratified our Constitution practiced the redress of grievances as an individual right. That was their intent. And not one word of these articles has been changed since 1792. They're still the same. The rights are still the same. Now, you may think that this work is going to overwhelm the legislature. And indeed, when we start out, there will be a lot of work. But once the officials and bureaucrats of this state learn that they can no longer abuse the people with impunity, the work will diminish. Now, the job of executing the Constitution, all of the Constitution, and not just the parts that you like, may be a lot of work. But if it's too much work for you, you probably ought to question whether you should be here. The choice before you is extremely clear. Did you or did you not swear to uphold this Constitution? Did you come here to defend the people's liberty? Will you, like Parliament, refuse to hear the people's petitions for the redress of grievance? Or will you defend their right to have the wrongs done them and the grievances they suffer heard in this legislature? It's that simple. Thank you.
The question before the House is on the adoption of the Majority Committee report of inexpedient to legislate on House Bill 1543. A roll call has been requested by Representative Itza. Is that sufficiently seconded? It does not appear to be sufficiently seconded. Oh, okay. It is sufficiently seconded. This will be a roll call vote. Will members please take their seats? The question before the House is on the adoption of the Majority Committee report of inexpedient to legislate on House Bill 1543. This is a roll call vote. If you're in favor, you'll be pressing the green button. If you're opposed, you'll be pressing the red button. And all members should be in their seats. The chair recognizes Representative Itza for a parliamentary inquiry.
Madam Speaker, fellow representatives, if you know as I know that the journals of this House testify that the redress of grievances was intended as an individual right, if you know as I know that the refusal of the legislature to hear petitions for the redress of grievances was the justification for the American War for Independence, if you believe as I believe that we do not have the right to deprive the people of their rights, If you are convinced, as I am convinced, that the American War for Independence was just, then will you please push the red button and vote against the committee report?
The question before the House is on the adoption of the Majority Committee report of inexpedient to legislate on House Bill 1543. If you're in favor, you'll be pressing the green button. If you're opposed, you'll be pressing the red button. Voting stations are open for 30 seconds. The House will be attentive to the state of the vote. 221 having voted in the affirmative, 106 in the negative, the Majority Committee report is adopted.